All right. So search engines, a brief introduction to people who are not who haven't attended the last classes. I think you guys should already know a little bit about what keywords are. So search engines, like search engines like Google, obviously Google is the biggest search engine. They work on the concept of keywords. So what happens is, whenever we put any kind of a query into the search engine, this query or question is matched with keywords in content. So Google will look at the query. They will try to interpret and understand the intention behind the query. Why are people asking this question? And depending on, and Google has a database of all the websites which have these queries as keywords. Google will try to match these queries with the keywords, and the most relevant result, according to Google, the most relevant result, matlab the most, the result which is most relevant to the search query and to the intent of the search query, is listed by Google in the search results. So there is a practice. The first step towards doing any kind of SEO is to understand all the keywords. Keywords or questions or problems that are in the mind of my consumer. So I need to understand all the keywords. So there is a process which is called keyword research. Using keyword research, I will be able to understand all the issues, all the problems which are on my user's mind, and I will get a list of keywords . This list of keywords I can put into my website, into my blog, so that whenever people search for these keywords, my website or my blog comes on the top. That is the fundamental of keyword research. I will also explain how it is done. We had talked about the process of keyword research in in detail in the last class, something that I will upload on YouTube, but I'll give you a very, very simple clue. The way to do keyword research, again, is very, very simple. The way that I'm telling you to do it is very, very simple. All you need to do is, you need to go to Google. You have to think of a keyword, one keyword, which is related to my brand or service. As an example, we had taken the example of digital marketing services. So my topic here was that I want to, I am the owner of a digital marketing agency. I want to make a website so that people who are looking for digital marketing services, content marketing services, social media services, they are looking for a digital marketing agency to outsource their work, they should be able to find me. So my idea is that people will be looking for a couple of keywords, and this has come from my brain. Main baitha, maine socha, and then I came up with a couple of keywords that if people were looking for my service, they would definitely be looking for digital marketing services, digital marketing agencies, or I am looking for digital marketing. Using these seed keywords, these are my seed keywords. I will use these seed keywords. I will keep putting these keywords into Google. And the suggested replies that come in the end, like people also searched for, whatever suggestions that are written are things which are related to this. So when people talk about digital marketing services, Google gives me a couple of suggestions ki haan, people are also looking for this. And this is in the search result. In the search result, I might have a section which says people also asked. These are questions that you've noticed. what I will do is I will take a spreadsheet, I'll take a list, I'll take a Excel sheet. In that Excel sheet, I will start noting down whatever keywords are coming from my Google searches. Because whenever I put one thing in Google, there will be some results which will come. I will take those results and put them in Google again. In practice, what you do is, if you're on desktop, you go to this keyword result, you do a right click and you open a new tab. In the new tab, you look at, you lift ki haan, 10 keyword aa gaye. 5 keywords have already been replaced. So, but then there are 8 new keywords. You start listing all of them. And what you do is, you list all of these into a clusters, into topic clusters. So if somebody is talking about digital marketing agency, you will have one cluster saying digital marketing agency. One will be a company cluster, etc. And what we did was, I'm going to share my screen. As an example, we all together, we did one exercise in which we did keyword research for digital marketing agency. I'll just share my screen with you. One second, please. And I'll show you the results that we got. And it is just a process. In a way, what we are doing is, we are taking our keywords and we are mining Google ke search results to find out all the related ways by which people are calling these services, people are looking for these services. Just sharing my screen. Okay, so this was the screen yesterday. This was the screen that we came up with yesterday. We found out that people are looking for digital marketing services location-based. So people are talking about digital marketing services in India, digital marketing services near me, etc., etc. As you can see here, there's a whole cluster and a whole classification of digital marketing services according to location. A lot of people are calling digital marketing services as, they're not looking for digital marketing services, they're looking for digital marketing service company. So here I have digital marketing service company, and that too location based. Some people are looking for, not for an agency or services, they're looking for a consultant. So this is the part for consultant. In Delhi, digital marketing agency, digital marketing location wise, and digital marketing consultant. All, and a lot of people are also looking for these things which are not directly related to digital marketing agencies, but they are topics which are still very important. People want to know which is the best digital marketing company. They want to know what services are offered by agencies. And obviously, if this is India, everybody is very concerned about cost. So before doing digital marketing or even thinking about it, a lot of people are looking at the cost of these services. What I have done here is very, very simple. It is something which you might say, yaar, ye to, like, this is so easy. Why is he even teaching us this? But no, that is not the point. When you do all of these searches, 20, 30 searches in Google, you will get all the ideas, all the things which are in the person's, in your customer's brain. And you will also understand the problems that your customer faces. For example, I know that a lot of people are looking for cost of digital marketing services. I could do a blog on my company page in which I could just talk about, in Delhi, what is the cost of digital marketing services divided by the type of services. So I could say that social media marketing costs this, SEO costs this, content management costs this. And even if I don't rank as a digital marketing agency, I will still rank for these keywords. I can make a complete blog where I talk about the cost of digital marketing services. And in the end of the blog, I will say, hey, you want digital marketing services? I think you need a quotation, right? I am going to give you a free quotation. Here's my number. Call me. Ping me on WhatsApp. No obligation. You don't need to talk to me. Just tell me your requirement and I will give you all the information about the digital marketing costs. This is the way to generate leads, because then if you have a customer calling you, that customer will sooner or later look for digital marketing services. You have caught them at a very early stage, and this is the secret behind keyword research. All right. So this is my short introduction. I'll take 10 to 20 minutes talking about other important concepts in digital marketing. All right. Now I have a very, very big question in my mind. Okay. I'll just stop sharing my screen. Assuming that my keyword, again, I'm going to take this keyword, the digital marketing agency wala keyword, as an example all around. I'll keep carrying this example forward aage bhi, so that, you know, we guys can kind of understand ki haan kya ho raha hai, kis tarike se chal raha hai sara kaam. Okay, so now There were a couple of questions yesterday as well, but there is one question which must be on everybody's mind. Okay. I did a lot of keyword research. Jaise Ashu ne bola, everybody would be saying, yeah, jaise Ashu ne bola, I spent an hour, I spent 2 hours, and I went through the process of putting those keywords into Google and getting the results out and putting those results in a complete list. I found out that digital marketing, my company, can be called a digital marketing agency. It can be called a digital marketing company. It can also be called as a digital marketing consultant. I have to make a website, and in the website, any web page, usually what we do is we will put an image on top. So I'll have an image on top. I'm talking about the home page of my website. And here I will have a headline, okay, saying, welcome to my digital marketing agency. Welcome to Ashu's digital marketing agency as seen on Zoom call. Now I'm really confused. The instructions for search engine optimization say, the first instruction says that there should be the keyword in heading. I am optimizing my website for these keywords, and I have discovered ki, oh my God, I thought that I was called a digital marketing agency. My job, my work is known as digital marketing company and digital marketing consultant as well. So ab kya karunga? What am I going to do? I can't have a heading which says digital marketing agency, digital marketing company, digital marketing consultant in Delhi. That will seem really, really odd. Anybody who wants to read it will be like, yaar, ye kya kar raha hai? He's just taking those keywords and he's just putting them in. So what I need to do is, I need to understand that for my web page, what are my focus keywords? A couple of people asked me, they've been asking me for a very, in the very initial classes, they asked me, they were like, Ashu, how many keywords can we optimize a web page for? Why are we doing keyword research? We are doing keyword research so that we rank on Google. How will we rank on Google? By finding out the keywords that are used to call my service, which are names for my service or product. For that, I did research, keyword research, and then I found out, oh my God, there are 3 keywords. Can I optimize all, can I make all 3 of these focus keywords? But that would be a problem. My answer was, when people ask me how many keywords can we use, we must first say that you need to understand the purpose of the page. If my page is very, very long, if my page is extensive, extensive content, and in that extensive content, I have covered 20 keywords, let me use 20 keywords in that content. Remember that there shouldn't be the number of keywords that you can optimize the page for only depends on the content of the page. So if I have a single page which says I am a digital, if I have a single page which says buy, for example, I'll just give you an example, buy XYZ brand phone, the purpose of the page is to, oh my God, you can't see it, I think. Okay. So if the purpose of the page is that it is supposed to sell XYZ brand phone, then you will have limited keywords. Then the keywords that you will use is buy XYZ phone, buy XYZ phone online. However, if the purpose of the page is the best phone in India, this topic in itself can cover a lot of, like, dozens of keywords. I can talk about best Android phone. I can talk about best iOS phone. I can talk about best Android phone below 20,000. I can talk about best iOS phone in 2019, 2020. This kind of content, which is very, very long, can be optimized for multiple keywords. You can have multiple sections in it. Again, I will not suggest that you take all the keywords in the world and you put them inside. My idea is that you make one content on best phone in India and you link it with related contents with different keywords. But then again, the number of keywords that you use depend on the purpose of the page. All right. So as the focus keyword, so imagine me as a digital marketing agency owner, the purpose of my page is to sell my services. And I found out that my services are not known by one name, they are known by three names. So this data is not enough. I would need two other pieces of information if my keyword is supposed to be, if my keyword research is supposed to be complete. The two pieces of information that I need are, so here I have my keywords. Okay. The other two pieces of information that I need is, I need the search volume. Search volume. People are looking for these keywords in Google. How many people are looking for digital marketing agency, for digital marketing company and digital marketing consultant? That is the search volume. This is a number which is an absolute number and it is an estimate. It is a monthly estimate averaged around the entire year. Okay. So I'll again talk about search volume here. Search volume is the number of searches per month. And it is an absolute number. So this piece of information, has to be found through tools. The keyword list can very easily be created using Google. But now if we have to go a step further, I need to know if I have to use this, this or this. And this, the search volume will partially tell me what is, like, which keyword should be used. My assumption here is, and I'm not doing any checking right now, I'm just giving an assumption. I assume that digital marketing agency, and oh, one more thing. This volume is according to the region. All right. I am doing SEO. I'm not saying I'm doing SEO. I want to rank in India. So these region, the volume that I'm looking for will be the volume in India. I cannot go ahead and do a research of volume in the United States and then come up with the answer. Both the keywords and the search volume and another factor that I'm going to talk about later are both very local. They are on, like, you know, country level. And if you are doing local SEO, as in you have a small business which is not across the country, these keywords, volumes as well as keywords, are also city wise. So you might be looking for search volumes in India and specifically in Delhi. Or I won't say Delhi. When you talk about Delhi, Delhi is not just one city. It is Delhi, Gurgaon, Noida, Faridabad. So it will be Delhi plus all the suburbs ka search volume. Assuming my search volumes are 100, 200 and 20. Absolute numbers. So what I mean by this is, keyword digital marketing agency in India, in city Delhi, there are 100 searches of this keyword per month. All right, I'm sure this is completely like, you know, completely clear. So now when I have to make a choice between, so now the keywords are telling me what people call my services. The search volume says how many people look for which word. Looking at these two, when I want to make my, when I, and I'm talking about here, I'm going to talk about my focus keyword. All right. I have 20, 30, 40, 50 keywords. Which one of those keywords will be my focus keyword? Obviously, the one with the maximum search volume. However, there is still something that we are missing. So first, I want to, again, there are not too many people today. There are 23 people. I think we can openly talk. Let's do an interlude right now. Do you have any doubts? Do you have any questions? Please ask. Seedha poocho. No problem. Speak out. If nobody has any questions, I'll just...
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir. देखिए एग्जाम्पल के लिए मैंने आज जैसे कि कीवर्ड रिसर्च की है सो एक ही चीज का डिफरेंट डिफरेंट सिनोनिम्स होता है डिफरेंट डिफरेंट नेम में यूज करते हैं
करेक्ट करेक्ट
तो वहां पे चूज करना कैसे होगा बिकॉज लाइक जैसे कि मैंने आज खुद को भेजा हुआ है तो सैनिटाइजेशन सैनिटाइजिंग सैनिटाइजर एक ही मतलब एक ही वर्ड है बट डिफरेंट फॉर्म है इसमें से कैसे चूज करेंगे
ओके सो द फर्स्ट थिंग विल बी नाउ व्हेन यू टॉक अबाउट आनंद यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट सिनोनिम्स Google is intelligent enough to distinguish between sanitizer, sanitization, sanitizing. All right, so that is no problem at all. I'm talking about completely different words. And even Google is even intelligent enough to know synonyms. There is an agency, there is, it is also called a company, it is also a consultancy. But in a way, we have to choose one focus keyword, and that focus keyword will be based on the search volume, and there will be one more thing. Deepak is asking me, is the search volume the search? Yes. The assumption here is that in 1 month in Delhi, India, 100 people are looking for this keyword. Anand, jara voice kam kar le, band kar de, ek bar mute. Thoda disturbance aa raha hai. 100 people, that is the volume of people. And again, this is an approximation. Believe me, there is nothing, this is not a concrete thing. But it is a relative thing. In a way, you can find out that 200 is better than 100. So my idea here is that I should rather use digital marketing company. So I should call my, so the website, when I want to optimize a web page for a keyword, I should say digital marketing company in the headline. And sub headline ke andar, we are a leading digital marketing agency based in India, based in Delhi. I'm not saying that you don't have to use like you cannot use more than one keyword, more than two keyword. But focus keyword, aapko ek ya do ya teen se zyada nahi lagne padte because these keywords need to be repeated in the headline, in the sub headline, in the meta, in the page title, meta keyword, etc., etc. All right. There is one more thing that I'm missing. Always, whenever you're talking about Google or whenever you're talking about any kind of marketing, forget about Google or forget about digital marketing. There is a very big thing which is competition. Competition. Suppose digital, you look at digital marketing company, you say ki it's got the highest, you know, search volume. But if in the, for that keyword, there are already competitors, it will be very difficult for you to rank. So there is another thing here, which is called the keyword competition. This keyword competition can be quantified in numbers or in letters. The Google AdWord tool, and I'm going to talk about tools also right now. There is a tool which is called Google Keyword Planner.
Sir?
Yes.
तो मुझे एक चीज क्लियर नहीं हुई कि सर्च वॉल्यूम पता कैसे लगता है कि 100 है या 200 है 20 है
I'm getting to it the next thing that I'm going to talk about is I'll do a demo I'll show you one free tool almost free tool by which you can get these numbers very very good question Tanya I'll get to it in just 10 minutes all right so there is one tool which is Google Keyword Planner there is another tool that we will be using right now because this is not a free tool This will be, it will give you results for free, but those results are not good. They are not accurate results. There is another one which is free, which is by Mr. Neil Patel, very, very famous digital marketer. Whosoever has learned any amount of digital marketing would have looked at Neil Patel's face. He will always be there saying, hey, I'm going to tell you how to, you know, make $1 million on the internet. He is a millionaire also, like much more than a millionaire also. There is another tool which is called Uber Suggest. This is the tool that we will be using for right now. Right now, this tool is free. Hota kya hai ki people make a lot of tools. These tools require money because they are computational. They need server space. So initially, they keep it for free. Abhi ke liye Uber Suggest is for free. The competition can be measured in two ways. Keyword Planner measures the competition in low, medium, and high. All right. It doesn't have a number associated with it. It simply says that the competition is low, medium, or high. Uber Suggests uses a scale between 0 to 100. Higher is higher competition. Okay. So if you have a 10 and a 90, this is high competition. This is low competition. All right. Now, again, my assumption here is, that this is medium competition, this is high competition, and this is, again, high competition. Or, if I were to talk about Uber Suggest, this could be something like 70, 75, and this could be 40. Remember, and this is, again, I'm not going to talk about, I can never lay down concrete rules here. Please remember my class. I can never lay down a concrete rule saying this is true, this is false. Digital marketing mein concrete cheeze nahi chalti. There is nothing like a absolute right and wrong. Just like in life, maybe this is not true in mathematics, but in digital marketing, there are suggestions. This thing might work, this thing might not work. All right. Usually, the rule of the thumb is, one of the very few rules is, and it is very, very logical also. You choose keywords with high volume and low competition. Not literally low, but lowest competition. All right. So looking at this, I would not choose digital marketing company. Because even though digital marketing has a very high search volume, highest amongst all three, the competition is also very high. It does not make sense to use, and again, I'm talking about my focus keyword. I'm not saying I will not mention digital marketing company anywhere. I will put digital marketing company's keyword somewhere inside the content or maybe in some heading. But my focus keyword here ideally should be digital marketing agency. All right. High volume. So if I start ranking for it, I will get more traffic. This traffic will be profitable to me. It will be worth the effort to get high volumes of traffic and low and medium competition. Like, you know, within these, there is no low competition here. It's only medium competition. So within these, it's the lowest competition. There are not too many people there. So it might be easy for me to get into this and rank for this. All right. I'll give you an idea of how we do this. All right. So we'll use a tool called Uber Suggest. I'm going to share my screen with you. One second. Okay, so it's Uber Suggest, it's on neilpatel.com. It's his URL called the Uber Suggest tool. All right. So what you do is, first of all, you'll go here. This, it has a place where you can enter the keyword. You can also enter domains. We'll be using this tool for a couple of other things as well. Uber Suggest Co. So here it talks about the domain or the keyword that I have to enter. I will go here. I will put India, obviously, because I'm looking for keyword research in India. Not obviously, maybe if I'm doing some research and I'm doing keyword research and I become an agency, I'm doing a research for Sri Lanka or maybe even for the states, then I will use the same region that I'm doing keyword research for. All right. I'll go to my keyword ka list, and this is my list that I made. I'll go for digital marketing services. I'll type it in. I'll click on it. You don't have to do it again and again and again. Achha, Neil Patel is asking me to sign in. All right. I'm not going to sign in right now. I'll do it using another email address, but I suggest that you sign in because when you sign in, you'll be able to get other related keywords and a lot of other information in addition to this. Okay. So here we go. Digital marketing services in India, according to Uber suggest, it is a high volume keyword, 9,900 searches per month within India, and it gives you an instead of competition, like I talked about competition, Neil Patel in his tool Uber suggests keyword difficulty as a keyword. So theek hai, keyword difficulty is kind of easy, it's 29. So I would say ki haan, this is a good keyword for me. What I'll do is, now in my sheet I will add two more rows. So this is my volume, and another one I will add, which will be the competition. Like I would say SEO competition. Okay. Now my keyword research will become technical. I will enter my volume, the volume which is for this keyword. All right. And I'll say that my SEO competition score, according to Neil Patel or whatever tool that I'm using, is 29. So what I will do is, I will say that TK digital marketing services is this volume. Now I here my objective is to compare between these three terms. So what I will do is, I will take my digital marketing consultant also here. It's just an example. All right. And digital marketing agency. All right. Because that's the question that I need to answer first. Ye teen maine yahan dale, digital marketing agency. That's it. All right, very quickly, I will put Uber suggest me. I don't think there is a way to put in bulk keywords at the moment, but in keyword planner, I cannot do. Kya kehte hain? I won't be able to do more than one search. Okay, I'll have to sign in eventually using my email address. New. All right, I'm signing in through Facebook, I mean through Google, because it's easier. Okay, digital marketing consultant in India using this tool, it's 1900, just as expected, it's not too much. And I think the competition should be lower. Look at this, the competition, the SEO competition is lower than the than digital marketing services. And similarly, I'll go for my digital marketing agency. I'll look for it. Wow, it's 14,800, a little difficult. So 14,800, that's a lot of volume. And in difficulty, it's just 33. So now if I have to make an intelligent choice between these three keywords, I would say that I would use digital marketing agency, and that will be my focus keyword. And a secondary keyword that I can use is digital marketing services. I'll try to sprinkle all these keywords everywhere. It's again not as simple as this, okay, but this is a beginner's this is a beginner thing that you can do, which you can use to find out the focus keywords that you want for your website. Any other question? Okay, Deepak is asking, sir, if volume is high, how is competition low? Not really, na Deepak. So people are also intelligent. So see, the highest volume, if I arrange these by the volume, the highest volume has the highest competition. The number two volume has the second number competition, and the minimum volume has the least competition. Because you remember, always remember, this is a competitive world that we are in. Everything that we do is relative to some other competitor who's also in Google, who's also standing and who's also presenting their page to Google's algorithm to say, okay, my content is better than this guy's content, this girl's content. All right. So it's always relative. Competition is also very important. People are doing a lot of keyword research, especially in competitive fields like insurance, banking, even digital marketing services. There is always a lot of competition. Okay. Now there is one last part that I want to talk about in 5 minutes. Okay. And after that, I will take Anand's keyword research. He's done very interesting keyword research, and then we will take it further. I'm a bit disappointed with everybody else. If I had a chocolate right now, and if this was a real class, I would have given it to Anand. So here it is, Anand, one chocolate to you, and nothing for anybody else, because you're not doing your assignments. You're just sitting here, and you're just reading and not practicing. All right, I'm not going to act like a teacher. Let me finish this last part, and then we will look at what Anand has done. We'll try to wrap this up by 6:10, 6:15. I'm very keen to put all those videos on YouTube. I can't do it while I'm giving the class. Mujhe pause karna pad, because it's taking a lot of my bandwidth.
Sir, sorry for interrupting, but जैसे आपने ये लिखा choose keywords with high volume and lowest competition, but जो हमने देखा उसमें तो मतलब अलग है अगर तीनों के comparatively.
हाँ, ये तो एग्जाम्पल था ना. एक मिनट, आप इसकी बात कर रहे हैं ना, जो मेरे को लाइक यू टॉकिंग अबाउट द
इवन आई हैड द सेम क्वेश्चन आशुतोष, जो कीवर्ड हमने ऑप्ट किया है मार्केटिंग एजेंसी वाला, तो उसका वॉल्यूम ज्यादा है बट कॉम्पिटिशन भी तो उतना ही ज्यादा है ना, 33.
हाँ, तो ठीक है. सो व्हाट आई कैन डू इज कि बट देयर इज नॉट मच ऑफ अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज ना. रिमेम्बर, इफ दिस वॉज लाइक 90, तब मैं इससे डर जाता. And again, this is just an example. And these are just three keywords. We have to look for more keywords also. Now look at this. Within 4 points of competition, nearly 5,000 volumes are within these 4 points. The priority for me here is, because agar inke beech mein bahut difference hota, agar ye 70 hota aur ye agar 10 hota, then definitely I would have gone for this. But that's not the case. They are very close by. And I'm not saying that I will only use one keyword and that's the end. What I'm saying is I will try to make my primary keyword digital marketing agency. And again, in theory, baad mein there's a lot of other things which come up. Clear? All right. Cool. I want to talk about the types of keywords. There are two distinctive types of keyword. Based on the number of words. A keyword is a phrase. So if I talk about digital marketing company and best digital marketing agency near me, this, the number of words in this keyword is 1, 2, 3 words. The number of these words is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is a 6 word ka keyword. This is a 3 word ka keyword. Based on the number of words, keywords are classified into short tail and long tail. All right. Again, this is not a short-tailed keyword. A short-tailed keyword could really be a keyword which has just got one or two, like just one, digital marketing, that's it. And another thing that you would have noticed, if I talk about digital marketing yaha, this keyword also exists here. Remember this. If in case you optimize the website for this, toh chote wale keywords toh optimize ho hi jate hai, because those keywords are within this. Google is able to read the whole thing overall. All right. So then, so in a way, a lot of people have classified. So I'm going to show you this graph, a curve, a very, very common curve. This is the x-axis. The x-axis is the number of words. Okay? The y-axis is the search volume. Low, high search volume, low number of keywords. So I would say here are 1, here are 2, 3. This is here. 2 yaha hai. So there is a curve which is defined between this as a relationship. This is the curve. So if you have, but like, you know, we must have all studied a bit of mathematics here. All right. Short keywords, short-tailed keywords. This I will call short-tailed keywords. Short-tailed keywords are have low numbers, high volumes. Long-tailed keywords have high number of words. Like this is a 6-word keyword, 3, 4, 5, 6. It has got a less volume. इसका वॉल्यूम अज्यूम कर रहा हूं 200 है एंड ये दो वाले का जो वॉल्यूम है मैं अज्यूम कर रहा हूं दिस वॉल्यूम इज मे बी 5000. अगेन दिस इज कंप्लीटली आउट ऑफ स्केल ऑल आई एम ट्राइंग टू एक्सप्लेन एंड इट मेक्स सेंस राइट इन अ वे डिजिटल मार्केटिंग विच इज अ शॉर्ट टेल कीवर्ड इज ऑल्सो हियर ऑल लॉन्ग टेल कीवर्ड्स कंटेन शॉर्ट टेल कीवर्ड्स अनदर थिंग शॉर्ट टेल कीवर्ड्स आर वेग कीवर्ड्स something like shoes, jute. It's really, really vague. Long tail keywords are very, very definitive. So it will be like best sport shoe for gym and running. Best sport shoe for gym and running under rupees 5000. This is not a joke. People are, as Google is getting more and more sophisticated. Back in the 2000s, 2002, 2004, I remember, if we would put a lot of keywords in Google, a long question, Google would get confused. Ab Google is sophisticated enough. To ab ek tarike se dekhiye, ye short-tailed keyword ho gaya. This keyword already exists here. So many queries which have a number of words in them, all of them contain short-tailed keywords. That is why short-tailed keywords have a lot of volume. However, long-tailed keywords have less volume, but they also have less competition. So one of the strategies that people use is, what they say is ki yaar, short-tailed keyword is very, very difficult to rank for. Because shoes pe to hazaro lakho, there will be billions of sites on shoes. Why should I not make a specific niche website? That is why a lot of you people would have heard, a lot of people say, how do you make, excuse me. A lot of people say, ki you want to start a blog, what is the topic that you should put your blog on? So a lot of people are saying, a lot of hustlers, jo hacker type hote hain, log, they're saying, always go for a niche. Niche hoti hai something which is related to a long-tailed keyword. Niche is something which is not very common. Very few people are looking for it, but there are also very few players in the market. So in a way, if you wanted to rank for a short-tailed keyword, it would require more effort than ranking for a short, a long-tailed keyword. Is pe bhi I will give you an example, a case study of, people who try to jack the system. But I think that, that can come later. Now, what we will do is, I will pick up, the session is over. I will now pick up the example, the keyword example that Anand used. And using that example, I'll take some questions and I'll be able to tell you ki kya cheez hai. Okay, sharing my screen. Great. Can you see it? No, yeah, this is the other one. This is Anand's keyword research. Oh. Huh. Okay, so Anand, I think you were doing a keyword research, like you were doing a very good keyword research, which is something which is very relevant right now. It's about home sanitization. One second. Because home sanitization services are very, very common at the moment. Everybody is looking for home sanitization services. All right. So this is the this is a keyword research that Anand has done for that. All right. So sanitization services near me. Okay. So he has sanitizer services, home sanitizer services. Okay. Office sanitizer. Very good. Sanitization services. Okay. Home, house sanitization, office sanitization. Okay, so your question was that there are three ways by which people are asking for this.
So like your home and house, the common word is kabhi home use karte hain log, kabhi house use karte hain word.
No problem. You can use either. And I don't even think that there will be much of a difference in this. I don't think there will be much of a difference here. So let us do this. Let us do a comparison between home sanitization service and house sanitization service. Try kare. Let me first see if these are keywords. Okay. Oh yeah. Home sanitizing services. Theek hai? These are keywords because it's very relevant right now. Okay. So I have matlab isko main thoda sa apna kalakari karta hu. What I'll do is I'll put this as home sanitizing services. Okay. And then house sanitizing services. Wo bhi hai, that's also a keyword. All right. I bet both of them will have a same volume. I have a feeling. Okay. This is Chota home sanitizing service 10 and 30. 10, 30. Now you know these numbers, right? This is my volume and this is my competition. These are chota volume ka keywords. Still, you've done a good job looking at all the keywords. Same. Das hai, but another thing is this is more competition. So I think more people are talking about house sanitizing rather than home. I would use house as a keyword. I'm sorry. I would use home as a keyword. Because house or home ke beech mein Google ko difference pata chal raha hai. All right. I really like the way that you have expanded and you have created these topic clusters. I would say ki ye sare teen same hai. Theek hai? So the main clusters is sanitizing, house and home. All right. Uske baad another related keyword that you've used is disinfection services. Okay. Or related jo hai companies aa gayi. Theek hai? Sanitizing companies. So people are at all saying, they are saying services, company. All right. The themes are services, company. Services and companies for home, services and companies for office. All right. And disinfection services. All right. Great. This is good work, Anand. This is really, really good work. But there is one step that you have missed here, Anand. Can we go ahead and can we look for some long tailed keywords which are related to this? For example, my first question is cost of home sanitization. All right, it's a valid thing. House cleaning prices. Let me see if there is something. House cleaning. Nahi, there are no keywords right now. I don't think there are keywords because aap dekhiye, sanitizing your home is something like a new concept, right? But in a way, the first answer that I get is from the US. So probably, and this is also for home cleaning services. And all the questions are also in cleaning. Oh, wow. Look, Broomberg is here, our company. Anand and I used to work for Broomberg pehle. Okay. And theek hai, I do not think there are a lot of long tailed examples. I think you've done really good research. I think sab kuch cover ho chuka hai. Okay.
There is now, like long tail, na? House cleaning and sanitization services near me.
Correct, correct. This is a long tailed key. Very good. Anand, I think when you did this, सब कुछ खत्म हो गया था ना, राइट? लाइक व्हेन यू स्टार्टेड डूइंग दिस, इट ऑल स्टॉप्ड, राइट?
जो सैनिटाइजेशन और डिसइंफेक्शन के वर्ड खत्म हो गए थे, देन क्लीनिंग आने स्टार्ट हो गए थे.
ओके, इन अ वे इट विल बी चेंज्ड. वन सेकंड. Okay, now I come to like the last part. We've been talking about keywords so much abhi tak, a lot of things about keywords. Anant ke example se, I want to talk about a very important thing, which is website structure. All right, a lot of people have asked me, ki sir, keyword research to kar li, like it's all right. We've done a lot of keyword research. I'm very, very happy. How does that help me in organizing my website? Through this example of home of sanitization services, मेरे को एक बहुत अच्छा लाइक यू नो अभी कैन गिव एन एग्जांपल. सो आई एम एन एंटरप्रेन्योर, आई एम रियली फास्ट, आई नो दैट दिस कोरोना वायरस प्रॉब्लम विल कंटिन्यू. ऑलराइट, आई हर्ड दैट देयर इज अ होम सैनिटाइजेशन सर्विस दैट आई कैन प्रोवाइड. इट्स अ सिंपल थिंग, आई कैन ईदर टेक स्टीम और आई कैन टेक लाइक यू नो सम काइंड ऑफ अ डिसइंफेक्टेंट. आई कैन गो इन होम्स एंड आई कुड जस्ट स्प्रिंकल डिसइंफेक्टेंट, क्लीन द डोर नॉब्स एंड ऑल द प्लेसेस जहां बहुत इंफेक्शन लगता है. सो नाउ व्हाट आई डू इज आई फाइंड आउट दैट माय सर्विस इज कॉल्ड होम या हाउस सैनिटाइजेशन. ओके, पीपल आर लुकिंग फॉर होम हाउस सैनिटाइजेशन अकॉर्डिंग टू लोकेशन एंड विद इन होम एंड हाउस सैनिटाइजेशन देर इज अनदर कैटेगरी विच इज ऑफिस सैनिटाइजेशन. ऑल राइट, सो इट्स नॉट जस्ट होम सर्विसेज. आई एम वेरी वेरी सॉरी, सैनिटाइजेशन सर्विसेज आर ऑन टॉप. Within sanitization services, it's sanitization services within locations. And then we have sanitization services for offices and for homes. And somewhere there's also a concept of cleaning, which is floating around. I'll just share the screen once again, if you guys hadn't followed it. Okay, overall sanitizing, we'll find out. Sanitizing overall, okay. Another thing is disinfecting. Disinfection services, and within sanitization, there is house and home sanitization and office sanitization. All right, and then there is another theme of company, okay, and disinfection services. Using this, I can really make the structure for Anand's website, which is very, very important. What I will have is, I will have a home page within the home page ke saath, I will have a services page, and within the service page I will have a office and a home service. My home page will be optimized for sanitization services, disinfection services, and for Delhi, because I am a Delhi business. Okay, my services page ke andar office will be optimized for sanitization, office sanitization. That's it. Office sanitization, office sanitizing, office disinfection, and home will be for home sanitization and disinfection. These keyword clusters, not only do they help you, with your to find out the keywords, they'll help you to organize your website. So Anand's website will look like this. Okay, there will be a home on the menu, there will be services ke niche there will be office and home, there will be a contact us page, and ek hum about page bhi bana sakte. This is it. My home page should rank for sanitization services, disinfection services in Delhi. My office sanitization will rank for office sanitization, office sanitizing, office disinfection, इन दिल्ली माय माय क्या कहती है होम हाउस दिस इज द होम होम पेज राइट यू नो द मेन पेज माय हाउस सैनिटाइजेशन विल बी रैंकिंग फॉर होम सैनिटाइजेशन होम सैनिटाइजेशन होम डिसइंफेक्शन सर्विसेज ऑलराइट आई विल नॉट गेट ग्रीडी आई विल नॉट पुश ऑल माय कीवर्ड्स इनटू वन आई नो की सैनिटाइजिंग सर्विसेज की अम्ब्रेला के अंडर and this is an answer that keyword research has given me and I can also have one more thing here I can also have a services for home cleaning kyun nahi why not have a service for home cleaning all right cool do you have any doubts anybody has any doubts I think you kind of understand from Anand's example it is very very clear कि क्या क्या होना है माई सजेशन एंड माई रिक्वेस्ट अगेन टू एवरीबडी इज प्लीज गो थ्रू डू कीवर्ड रिसर्च इफ यू आर वेरी सीरियस अबाउट इट मतलब एक तो चीज होती है जिसको ना लाइक सी इट स्पेशली पीपल हु आर इनटू द लर्निंग फेज आई वुड सजेस्ट दैट ऑल ऑफ यू गो अहेड एंड डू कीवर्ड रिसर्च लेट्स डू एक्सटेंसिव कीवर्ड रिसर्च फॉर द डिजिटल मार्केटिंग एजेंसी का कॉन्सेप्ट लेट्स फाइंड आउट हाउ वी विल ऑर्गेनाइज द वेबसाइट व्हेन वी स्टार्ट मेकिंग इट Let's find out which keywords will be optimized. So again, I'm telling you and I'm requesting you again, assignment again, same thing, digital marketing services, that sheet, use that sheet to do keyword research, use Uber Suggest to find out the keyword volumes and the competition. And then later on, using those keywords, we will decide how many pages in the website to put, what will be the page titles and which keywords will the pages be optimized for. All right. Any other and Anand, thank you so much. Very very good work, Anand.
Thank you, sir.
Very very good work. You know, a couple of things which came out from there. First was the thing of synonyms. Synonyms focus keyword mein chalte hain. In fact, I had talked about Yoast SEO. In Yoast SEO, you have to put in your focus keyword, and you can also put a synonym inside it. Google is very intelligent, understanding synonyms. In fact, you should put synonyms and related keywords into your content to make Google understand ki what the content is all about. Google request kar rahe hai aapse, they want you to make a website in a way so that you can understand what is the purpose of the page. Once again, I've been repeating this for 200 times. Ye aapka customer hai, ye aap ho. Iske beech mein Google ki diwar hai. Google people are looking, your customers are looking at Google. Your customers are Google ke customers. If you are able to satisfy Google ke customers, Google is wall ko gira dega and you will be connected with your customer. So you need to really understand what they want, their needs, and there is no better way to understand this than using your keyword research. One very last thing, 5 more minutes. YouTube ki keyword research. Okay, dikhao. Same thing hai. It's the same thing. Patak, you are smiling. Patak knows this very, very well, Deepak. Huh? Okay, today I was on YouTube and I started doing research for the channel that I'm creating. My seed word would be learn digital marketing. Ye lijiye. Here are all the keywords. Okay, so now people are looking for learning of digital marketing in Hindi. They want a online course for free in Hindi, beginner. All right, beginner in Hindi, free online. This is the first thing. So if I talk about the cluster which says learn digital marketing, inside I will make separate clusters for Delhi Hindi, beginner's course, maybe advanced course, step by step. Some people are looking for digital marketing. ये देखिए इतना डाला digital marketing course आ गया. So another keyword cluster will be digital marketing course. A lot of people are not calling a course by course. They are also calling it a tutorial. ये लीजिए. YouTube keyword research. There are 2000 fancy tools to do it. However, the best way to do YouTube keyword research is through this. Is doing. You know the basic keyword research through YouTube, through Google search, because everything is here.
Ashutosh, how do you find the search volumes for YouTube?
There are tools for it. Those tools are very, very inaccurate. Okay, so my suggestion here is, like, there are also like Ahref, there is a very, very paid, we use one tool which is called vidIQ. So vidIQ gives a relative score. It's a very, very famous tool. What it does is, it gives you two scores. I'll talk about it later. But abhi ke liye my idea here is, let's not go for volumes. Matlab YouTube mein toh zaruri bhi nahi hai. YouTube mein kya hota hai? You have to put those keywords in the description. You have to put those keywords in the tags. So uske andar toh you can put a lot of keywords. All right? And I'll come down to it. The main idea here is to find out all the keywords which are related. Ahref is a paid tool. It's $100 per month. That has a very good keyword database for YouTube. Otherwise, there is another tool which is called vidIQ. I think it's very cheap. One license for 1 month is, I think, $5 or something. I might be wrong. All right. So you can use those for volumes. But let's forget about volumes. Let's simply talk about how do people look for my things. I will optimize my YouTube channel videos in this method. And I will also show it to you. At least, I can show you examples. It's all for learning. Everything is for you. All right. Cool. Thank you so much. I will try to upload all the videos today. Anybody who hasn't attended Purani Wali classes, you can look at those videos. And as usual, if there are no questions, you've been a great class. Tomorrow I need to take a break. We will have a class day after tomorrow, 6:30 onwards. All right. I have a lot of otherwise work to do. Hopefully, by day after tomorrow, you will have all the videos for all the classes along with the guide. I'm working on it. I'm just very, very busy this weekend. There's too many things to do. All right. You've been a great class, everyone. Thank you so much, Priyanshu, everyone. I'll share the link for the channel. Abhi, there aren't any videos on it. It's called UX Vernacular, but abhi usme koi videos hi nahi.
Sir, any homework?
Same thing, Anand, you've done your homework. Can you do this for digital marketing? Aise practice ke liye. And everybody else, you have to do it for digital marketing because, disinfection is chota, but digital marketing is very, very big. All right, and I especially want you to look for long-tail keywords. When people are thinking of digital marketing, what else are they looking for? All right?
Done, sir.
Thank you so much. Have a great day, guys. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.